bed at 100 nickels and it coughed up 5.
Must have had indigestion.
Yeah, I'm going to speak to Chief about them slots.
Well, I guess the Chief Torrance has got more to worry about than the slot machines and pinball games and that confectionery.
Oh, you're not telling a lie. Last time I seen Dr. Johnny, I asked him what were the facts about Chief Torrance's operation in Memphis.
Well, what did he tell you, Beulah?
Well, he said the worst thing a doctor ever can say.
What's that, Beulah?
Nothing at all. Not a spoken word did he utter.
He just looked at me with those big dark eyes of his and shook his head like this.
I guess he signed Jane Torrance's death warrant with just that single silent motion of his hand.
Well, that's exactly what passed through my mind. I understand they cut him off.
And filled him right back up, is what I heard.
Well, I didn't know these dogs had seeds in them.
He thought they were stuffed.
You best not be snooping around upstairs.
Lady catches you out, she'll give you a touch of her tongue. She's not a day go for nothing.
No. You spoke a true word, honey. Well, I was surprised when I went up myself earlier.
You went up yourself earlier?
I did. And so did you, because I seen you, Beulah.
Well, I never said I didn't. I mean, curiosity is a human instinct.
You know what it seemed like to me up there? A county jail. I swear to goodness, it didn't seem to me like a place for white people to live in. Mm. That's the truth.
Well, I wasn't surprised. Jay Torrance bought that woman.
Bought her?
Yes, bought her. When she was a girl of 18. He bought her, and he bought her cheap. She'd been thrown over and had a heart broken by David Dupree. You know Carol Dupree's big brother.
Oh, what a beautiful black man was.
Oh, when those two met, it was like you struck two stones together and made a fire. Anyway, he quit Lady to some of the mystic who set fire to her father's wine garden for selling liquor to niggas. And Lady's father was burning alive fighting fire.
Oh, Lord have mercy.
Mm-hmm. And I second the motion. Anyway, after that happened, David wanted no further connection to Lady, and he thrown her over.
Speaking of great.
Now, somebody don't seem to know that the store is closed.
Can you understand how anybody would deliberately make themselves look as fantastic as that?
Well, some people can't show off anything on earth to attract attention.
I'm on 2 lane 0370 in the Owens.
What's she doing barefooted?
Well, last time she was arrested on the highway, they said she was naked under her coat.
I'm waiting. I caught the heel of my slipper and my rotten boardwalk out there, and it just about broke right off. They say if you break the heel of your slipper in the morning, it means you meet the love of your life before dark. But it was already after dark when I broke the heel of my slipper. Maybe that means I'll meet the love of my life before morning. Just keep on ringing, please. He's probably drunk. Sometimes it takes quite a while to get through the living room furniture.
She's a sight. Uh-huh, a sight to be seen.
Buddy? Carol! Hi, doll! Did you trip over something? I thought I heard a crash. Oh, baby, I'm on the way already. Everything's all fixed. I got my allowance back. On condition I remain forever away from Two River County. Oh, I had to blackmail them a little bit. Came down to dinner with my eyes made up, wearing my crazy black sequin jacket. And Betsy Boo, my brother's wife, said, Carol, you going to a fancy dress ball? I said, oh no, I'm just going juking tonight up and down the Dixie Highway between here and Memphis, like I used to when I lived here. Well, honey, she flew by me so fast I couldn't see her passing. When she came back on in, the ink was still wet on the check. And this will be done once a month. As long as I stay away from Two River County. Oh, baby, I'm talking straight through. Not even stopping for pickups. Unless you need one. Meet you at the Starlit Lounge before it closes. Oh, if I'm irresistibly delayed, I'll certainly meet you at the morning call for coffee. Okay, baby. Bye-bye now.
Oh, let's see now.
Somebody, I want to be sure it's somebody I want to stop for.
Sheriff Taylor ought to know about this when he gets back to the
the old condiment and we'll get off you.
Hey, Uncle Pleasant. Come here, Uncle. Let me see what you got there. Oh, you got some bones of some kind. No, Uncle, I don't want to touch them. They're not clean yet. There's still some flesh clinging on them. You take them and you put them on a bare rock and you let the sun and the rain burn away and wash away the corruption. And then there'll be a good charm, Uncle. Then there'll be a good charm. Hey, Uncle. Give us a chop cow cry. He's part chop cow. He knows the chop cow cry.
Oh, don't let him holler in here.
Come on, Uncle. You know it. Cuckoo, 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 cuckoo.
$25 with the same sweet message. I love
the bar where you were standing, touched old Jackie and said, what stuff is this made of? And when you said,
nice.
I wish you would have told me that before I touched it. Then you said something not nice. You said, Mikey, that will learn you to hold back your hand.
I was drunk by this time, which is after midnight.
Remember what I said to you then? I said, what on earth can you do on this earth but catch and whatever comes near you with both hands and hold on until your fingers are broken? I don't ever remember having said that before, or even consciously thought it. But afterwards, it seemed like the truest thing my lips had ever spoken. What on earth can you do but catch it, whatever comes near you, and hold on until your fingers are broken?
You gave me a quick, sober look.
I think you nodded slightly.
Then you picked up your guitar, you began to sing. After singing, you passed the cue. Whenever paper money was dropped in the kitty, you blew a whistle. My cousin Bertie and I dropped in $5. You blew the whistle 5 times. And then you came and sat down at our table for a drink. Shin legs and 7 up. And you showed us all the signatures on your guitar.
Any corrections so far?
Why are you so anxious to prove I know you?
Because I want to know you better and better. I want to go juking with you.
Yeah, what's juking?
You know what that is. That's when you get in your car and you drink a little and you drive a little and you stop and you dance a little to a jukebox. Then you get back on in your car and you drink a little more and you drive a little more and you stop and you dance a little more to a jukebox. Then you stop dancing. And you just drink and drive, and you stop driving, and you just drink. And then finally, you stop drinking.
What do you do then?
Well, that depends on the weather and who you're drinking with. If it's a clear night, you spread a blanket among memorial stones up on Copper Hill. That's a local bone orchard. But if it's not a fair night, and this one certainly isn't, well, then usually you go up to the Wildwood Cabins between here and Sunset on the highway.
Not what I figured. You got, I don't go that route anymore. Heavy drinking, smoking the weed, shacking the street. It's okay for kids in their 20s. My 30th birthday. I ain't young anymore.
You're young at 30. I hope so. I'm 27.
You ain't in 30. We've been on a goddamn party since you've been 15. Well, a tree grows in my backyard. Only grows at night at the branches they twisted. Leaves are frail like they say that blues is just a bad dream. They live upside your head. Well,
thank you.
lots of nickels been on one of our bandits in there.
That pinball machine's hot as a pistol.
Jeez. Oh, can you believe it, James here?
Oh, have a dog. Don't be a mom.
Oh, I can't help it. It's so wonderful to see James again. Oh, James, bless
him. I just said, it looks like he's been Miami with that pony, something.
I ain't been out, no son. And if y'all excuse me, I'm going to do my celebrating upstairs in bed.
Mm-hmm.
Because I'm kind of worn out.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. See, there's been some changes made around here. I come to shoot bombers back out here now.
Well, you know we always have a problem with light in the storage.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. So you moved the shoot bombers back out here away from the front window. That's sensible. Yeah, a downright brilliant solution to the problem.
I told you, I got a flesh and bolt coming into work back here, huh?
Uh-huh. I'm going to tell you something. Tomorrow, I'm going to give me some niggers in here. We're going to move the shoot bombing back out front.
Mm-hmm. You do whatever you want to. It's your store.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Thank you for reminding me of that.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus.
That man will never come down those stairs again. Never in this world, honey.
Oh, he has a dead sweat on. Lady, I don't suppose you must feel like talking about it right now.
Oh, Pee-wee and me are so worried. Oh, Joel and me are worried sick about it.
About what?
About Jane's operation in Memphis.
Was it successful?
Wasn't it successful?
Was it too late for surgical interference?
Wasn't it successful? We hope and pray it ain't hopeless.
Excuse me, I've got to go upstairs. She's talking for me.
Speaking of knocks, I have a knock in my engine. Because knock, knock, and I say, who's there? I don't know whether I'm in communication with some dead-end system or the motor's about to chop at me and strand it dead of night in the middle of the Dixie Highway.
Do you have any knowledge of mechanics?
I'm sure you do. Would you be sweet? Come for a short drive with me so you could hear that knock. What do you got to do?
I got a steamboat getting work in the store.
I'm offering you a job.
I need a job with me.
I expect to pay you.
Make some time tomorrow.
I can't stay here overnight. I'm not allowed overnight in this county. Can you hear what those women are saying? Can you hear what those women are saying about me?
Lady Cool.
I don't like playing it cool. What are those women saying about me? Are they saying I'm the greatest?
You don't like people talking about you. Why do you make up with it?
Just you all. I want to be noticed, seen, heard, felt. I want them to know I'm alive. Don't you want them to know you're alive?
I want to live. I don't care if they know I'm alive or not.
Why do you play that guitar?
Why do you make a goddamn show of yourself?
That's right, for the same reason.
We don't go the same route.
I used to be what they call a Christ bitten or a funk. You know what that is? A kind of benign exhibitionist. I delivered stump speeches, wrote letters of protest about the gradual massacre of the colored majority in the county. I thought it was wrong that playground slow starvation should cut them down when the cotton crop failed due to army wearing boll weevil or too much rain in the summer. I wanted to. I tried to put up three clinics. I squandered the money my mother left me on it. When that Willie McGee thing came along, he was put to the chair for having improper relations with a white whore. I made a fuss about it. I put on this potato sack and set out on foot for the Capitol. This was in winter. I walked barefoot in this burlap sack to deliver a personal protest to the governor. Oh, I suppose it was partly exhibitionism on my part, but it wasn't completely exhibitionism. There's something else in it, too. You know how far I got? 6 miles out of town. Hooted at, jeered at, even spit on. Every step of the way. And finally, arrested.
Guess what for?
Louis.
revisionist. Now, I want you to do something for me. I want you to take me up to Cypress Hill in my car, and we can hear the dead people talk. They do talk up on Cypress Hill. They chatter together like birds. But all they say is one word, and that word is live. It's all they know. It's the only advice they can give. Just live, 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 live. Come on, boy. Hit my shoe.
Honey. You might as well face it, Bea. That is one candidate for salvation you have lost to the opposition.
He's going off to Cypress Hill with that Capri girl.
If some of you older women in Tenderness County would set a better example, there would be more decent young people.
What was that remark?
I mean, the people who give drinking parties and get so drunk they don't know which is their husband, which is someone else's, and people who serve on the altar guild and still play cards on Sunday.
You just stop right there! I have now discovered the source of that dirty gossip.
I'm only repeating what I've been told by others. I've never been to those parties.
No, and you never will.
You're a public killjoy.
Hey, professional hypocrite.
I try to build up people's characters. You and your drinking parties are only concerned with tearing characters down. I'm going upstairs. I'm going back upstairs.
Good. Well, I'm glad I said what I said to that woman. I have no earthly patience for that sort of hypocriticism. Come on, darling. Let's get this perishable stuff and leave here. I've never been so thoroughly disgusted.
My lord.
You think I'm sweet enough? Common as dirt.
I heard her say, Dallas folks from Blue Mountain ain't nothing but the poorest kind of white trash. And I heard Lolly Tucker say, my old man sits on the porch with his shoes off, drinking beer out of a bucket. Let's take some flowers and put them on the altar.
Next good idea. We can give Jay credit for parish notes.
We'll come in handy at the bishop at a judgment's
key. Uh-huh. Sits on the porch with his shoes off?
Well, it looks to me like old Jay will be going under before the coffee comes up. Never did look good. Now he looks worse. Where the hell is my wife? Babe!
Oh, hush, that fowling. I had to speak to Nitty about that boy, and I couldn't do it in front of Jay because he thinks he's going back to work himself.
Well, I'll move along, Mama, and will you quit fooling?
I think I'll wait until that boy gets back.
I am sick of you making a damn fool out of yourself over every stray bastard that wanders into this county.
Please. I know the drugstore's closed. It's Mrs. Thomas, and the store's closed too. Yes. I just brought my husband back from the hospital. Yes, yes, it's an emergency. Then Prince Serena has to be in the store. Yes, it's an emergency. Oh, I wish I was dead, dead, dead.
No, you don't, man.
What are you doing in this store? You know it's closed.
I've seen the light was on, the door was open, so come back.
You see what I got in my hand?
Take it easy, man. You gonna shoot me?
Sure will if you don't get out of here, mister.
Just come back and pick up my guitar.
To pick up your guitar?
I was here when you got back from Memphis. Miss Talbot brought me here. Don't you remember?
Oh. Yeah. You've been here all this time?
Oh, I'm out. Come back.
Oh, yes. Well, keep ringing until he answers. Keep ringing. You went out and come back?
That's right. Do you remember that girl who's here?
Girl who trapped?
Mm-hmm. She says she had a car trouble. I could fix it for her.
Did you fix it?
Oh, she didn't have a car trouble. That wasn't her trouble. Oh, she had trouble all right, but that wasn't it.
Yeah, what was her trouble?
She made a mistake about me.
A mistake?
She thought I had a sign, male stud hung on me.
She thought you... Oh, Mr. Dubinsky, I'm sorry to wake you up. But I just brought my husband back from the men's hospital, and I left my room in the cabin too. I got to have something like that, and I slept for 3 nights of falling to pieces. Now you listen to me. If you want to keep my trade, just send somebody over here with the tablets. You understand me? Then bring them yourself, goddammit, because I'm falling to pieces right now, huh? I'm shivering. It's as cold as an ice plant in this place. Now what do you want? I have to go upstairs.
Here, put this on.
What is this stuff this thing's made of, huh? It looks like snakeskin.
Yeah, well, that's what it is.
What are you doing with a snakeskin jacket?
Oh, it's sort of a trademark. People call me snakeskin.
Who calls you snakeskin?
Oh, the bars and sorts of places I work in. But I'm all through with that now.
You're a entertainer?
Sing. Play guitar.
Ooh. It's warm, right?
It's warm for my body, I guess.
You must be a warm-blooded boy, yeah? What do you want around here?
Well, work.
Boys like you don't work.
What do you mean boys like me?
Ones that have a guitar and a snakeskin jacket and go around and talk about how warm they are.
It happens to be the truth. My temperature's always a couple of degrees above normal. Same as a dog. Normal be the same as a dog. That's the truth. You don't believe
it? Well, I have no reason to doubt it, but what about it, huh?
Well, nothing.
Well, you're a peculiar somebody, all right. You sure are. How did you get around here?
Well, driving through here last night, the axle broke on my car. I went to the county jail for a place to sleep out of the rain. Miss Talbot, sheriff's wife, took me and she gave me a cop, the hoose gal. Told me if I went around till morning, you might give me a job in the store. About it, since your husband was taking a second off.
Well, she got the wrong information. I'm going to hire somebody. It has to be somebody local. I cannot hire a stranger with a guitar and somebody who runs the temperature as high as dogs.
Keep it on.
No, I've got to go upstairs and you had better be going.
I got nowhere to go.
Well, everybody's got a problem and that's yours.
I'm not smelling you.
Why do you ask me?
You seem to be like a farmer to me.
Well, I'm a daughter of a Wapu tiger that was killed here. It's a well-known story. Well, I need to go for her. The door locks behind you, huh?
I do electric repairs. I do all kinds of art jobs, eh? I'm 30 years old. I'm through with that old life I believe. I live through corruption. Well, I'm not corrupt. Here's why. My life's companion. Washes me clean like water when anything unclean can touch me.
What's her death writing on it?
Autographs, musicians.
Can I see it?
Come on around here. You see that name right there? Led Belly?
Led Belly?
Mm-hmm. Greatest man ever lived with a 12-string guitar. Played it so good he broke the stone heart of Texas governor. Won himself a pardon out of jail. See that name there? Oliver?
Mm-hmm.
King Oliver. His name is immortal, eh? Greatest man since Gabriel on my home.
What's his name here, huh?
That name. There's another immortal. The name Bessie Smith. Written in the stars. Jim Crow killed him. But John Barleycorn and Jim Crow killed Bessie Smith. He blended that back one all the way up there. Take them all by a hospital. See that name there? There's another immortal.
Blind Lemon Jefferson, huh? Is his name written in the stars too?
Yeah. His name is written in the stars too.
You had any sales experience?
Oh my, I've been selling something.
Well, so is everybody else. Now you got a character letter, a reference on you?
I do. I have this letter right here.
Guitar, Karen. That's why I had to let him go, even though I would have liked to have kept. about you don't mean much. Can you reach two sizes?
I guess so.
What does 75 dubbing mean? 75 means 70½ inches long, and D for David means D wide, huh? Can you count?
I can count.
Can you make change?
I can make change, it'll still.
Change for better or worse, huh? Well, you see that room beyond there? That's going to be the new confectionery. I've got it all planned. I'm going to compete for the nightlife, the after movies, trade. I'm going to redecorate it. I'm going to set it up somewhere. I'm going to have artificial flowers and branches all over the walls and the ceilings. It's going to be like an orchard in the spring. My papa, he had an orchard. He had 15 little tables in the arbors, and they were all covered with grapevines. And he would serve table red wine and bootleg whiskey and beer. Huh. Until they burned it up one summer.
Who burned it up?
Oh, an outfit in this county called the Mr. Crew. They drove up there one night, low torch, gallons of coal oil, and they set the whole orchard on fire. Oh, I want you to know that not one fire engine came out of the station that night. And my papa, he grabbed a blanket, and he ran up into the orchard and tried to fight the fire signal in heaven. And he was burned alive. He was burned alive. I heard him screaming. I ran and I fell. I saw him come toward me with his clothes on fire. Never I see a man in this company. I wonder if he was one of them. They set that whole orchard on fire. Oh, Mr. Dubinsky, thank you for coming. I'm sorry to wake you up. And...
Oh, you go to hell, you bastard.
You ever have trouble sleeping, huh?
I can sleep or not sleep. For long or so when I want to.
Is that true?
I can sleep on a concrete floor, but go without sleep. Not even feel asleep for 48 hours. I can hold my breath for 3 minutes. Paid $10 better than once, and I could do it, and I did. I can go a whole day without passing water.
Is that a fact?
That's a fact. Through town, a chain gang wants for babies. The town will poke all day. Stood there all day, not passing water, just to show them sons of bitches I can do it.
Well, you're a peculiar talker, all right. Tell me more about your perfect functions.
Wait. They say a woman can burn down a man, but I can burn down a woman.
Yeah? Which woman?
Any two-footed woman?
Well, there are a lot of two-footed women around here who would like to test the teeth of that stick.
Saying I could. I'm not saying I would.
Yeah, well, don't worry, boy. This is one to woman. Two-footed woman, you don't have to convince of your perfect controls, huh?
I'm all done with all that.
Oh, what's the matter, huh? They tire you out?
Tired. I'm fed up.
Fed up, huh?
I'm telling you, there's people bought and sold in this world like carcasses of hogs and butcher shops.
Yeah, you ain't telling me nothing I don't know.
You may think there are many, many kinds of people in this world, but lady, there's only two kinds. The ones that are bought and the buyers. Oh, there's a third kind, too.
Yeah, what kind is that?
Bones like me. Character references that describe them as crazy. You know what I think people call me crazy?
Why?
I think they mean I don't have my 2 feet on the ground.
Oh, you rise above it.
Out this wide, it was transparent, the color of the sky.
gonna get you. They'll see him up there in the high blue sky. Next song.
Oh, how about them gray weather, huh?
Fly so high in gray weather. The goddamn hawks will get dizzy. Those little birds, they don't have any legs at all. And they spend their whole life on a wing. And they sleep. Spread their wings. They sleep on the winds. Like other birds folk when they sleep on a tree. Sleep on the wind. Never allow themselves but one time. And they die.
I'd like to be one of those birds.
So I'd like to be one of those birds. But lots of people like to be one of those birds and it could be corrupted.
One of those birds should ever die, and you happened to find it down when you crossed through the earth. I wish that you would show it for me, because I think that you only imagine that such a bird lives in existence. Because I don't think that nothing has ever been that free, not even nearly. You show me one of them birds, and I'll say yes. God has made one perfect creature. Oh, I would give everything in the store. Just to be a tiny bird, the color of the sky, for one night to float on the wind around under the stars. Because I live with this friend of the beach who bought me a fire sale. And not once in 15 years have I had a good dream. Not one! Oh, hell, why am I telling you this, huh? Here, take this dollar and go up to the all-night diner and get yourself something to eat. You must be hungry, and come back here in the morning, and I'll start you in clerking. I'll start you in here, and perhaps when the confectionery opens, I'll put you in there, huh? But let's get one thing straight, huh?
Well, what's it?
I'm not interested in your perfect functions. In fact, I have no interest anymore in the area that you stand in. If you have that understood, we'll have a good working relation. Otherwise, trouble, huh? I know you're crazy, but there are lots of crazy people in this world, and they're in higher positions, too. So go and eat. You're hungry, huh?
Thanks, lady. Do you mind if I leave this here? My life's content?
Leave it here if you want to.
I don't know nothing about you, except you're nice. You and Miss Telly? Two of the most nicest people I ever have wanted you. I'll never stay. An honest and hard worker just to please you. Oh, and by the way, I can solve that sleeping problem of yours.
How?
Lady Osteopath taught me how to make little minor adjustments in the neck bone and spine. Who do you sound natural sleep? Good night.
Big diamond key trucks and trailers went off the highway last night.
Yes.
Six mule team is trying to pull them back off.
Thank you for calling. We just now got a big fat complaint about you from a woman who said if she wasn't a widow that her husband would come here and beat it out.
Yeah, yeah. She's a small pig-headed woman.
Skin-headed woman, did you say?
Not pink. A small pink-haired woman wearing a checkered coat with pearl buttons is big of her.
I don't know anything about her affairs. I just talked to her on the phone. She said your behavior was weird. Now I told you, a week ago and a half, you know monkey business here, boy, huh?
This little pink haired woman come in and bought a valentine off of me. All I think was my name is Valentine to her. A few minutes later, a small colored boy come in with a valentine and something written on it.
Didn't keep this date, did you?
No, ma'am. And that's why she complained.
catch up in the dark.
You bug for storage or something?
Would you walk around the perimeter like that?
Like what?
Slew foot? Huh? Did you stand around in front of her like that, that close, in that position?
What position?
Everything you do is suggestive.
Just for what?
Of what you said was true. Or, should you know what I mean now? Why do you think I give you the dog business of some work here?
Mm-hmm.
What are you doing?
Give me back the seat. Change my pants in the closet.
Hello. I said I'm sorry, huh? I think I sleep very well last night. I said I'm sorry.
Hey, lady, get back my guitar.
I'm not going to give back my guitar.
I'll try to do good.
Lift me that ugly shoes, huh?
Just give me back my guitar.
I am not disappointed in you. I'm not.
Yeah, we sure don't show it.
My nerves are all shot. Shake, huh?
You mean I'm fired? So I don't have to quit?
We're just getting to know one another, huh? We're just getting acquainted.
Yeah, that's right. We have a couple of animals sniffing around each other. How does people get to know each other? I used to think they did by touch.
By what?
By touch of each other.
You mean by close contact?
Mm-hmm. But later. I seem to make them more strange for now.
Then how do you think they get to know one another?
Well, I answered your question, I'd say this. No one ever gets to really know no one. We're all offense to it. Solitary confinement. Inside our own skin for as long as we live, baby. You understand that? Each one of us is subject to a lifelong solitary confinement. Inside our own lonely skin for as long as we live on this earth.
I'm not a big optimist, but I cannot agree with such a sad statement as that.
Listen, when I was a kid, on Witch's Bahi, my folks all scattered away like loose chickens feathers blown by the wind. I stayed there on the bayou, hunted, trapped out of season, hid from the law. All that time, I thought I was waiting for something.
What were you waiting for?
I wasn't the one waiting for. Something to happen, anything to happen, to make things make more sense. It's hard to remember what that fiddle was like, because I lost it.
It's like if you ask a question, you wait for someone to answer. But if you ask the wrong question,
or you ask the wrong person, the answer never comes. Does everything stop just because you don't get the answer? Keeps on going right on, as if the answer was here. Day comes after day, night comes after night. Life just keeps going right on.
And then what?
Well, then you get the make-believe answer.
You make believe
that? Don't pretend you don't know that, because you do.
Love?
That's the make believe that. Fooled many a fool besides you and me, lady. That's the God's truth. I met a girl in the bayou when I was 14, and I had a feeling that day that if I just kept pulling that boat down the river just a bit further, I'd come bang right into whatever it was I've been so long expecting.
Was she the answer, or this girl in the bayou?
She made me think she was.
Yeah, how did she do that?
By coming out of the dog trot of a cabin as naked as I was in the bottom of that flat bottom boat. She stood there for a while with the sun blazing around her. Right as heaven, as far as I could see. You ever seen inside of a shell, how wide it is, that pearly white? Her naked skin was like that. Oh God, I remember a bird flown out of the moss and its wings put a shadow on it. And suddenly it sang a high, clear note. As if that was a signal for her to catch me. She turned, she smiled, she walked around back in that cabin.
You follow?
Yes, I follow. I follow like a bird's tail follows a bird. I follow. She made me think she was the answer I was waiting for. But later, the question wasn't much plainer than the answer. 15, I left Witch's Bayou. My dog died. Sold my boat and my gun. Went to New Orleans. I seen this getting jacket there. It did take me long to learn the score.
What did you learn?
I learned I had more things to sell besides snakeskin. It's another wild,
scalping, skin, I called the body. I was corrupted. That's the answer.
No, that's not the answer.
No? You tell me the answer.
I don't know the answer, but I know that corruption is not the answer. Because if it was, I'd take jibs, so piston or his morphine tablets, and I gotta get you a phone. Oh, go ahead. Yourself, you
Couture place, get me the Couture place. David or his wife, whoever comes to the pump.
Lady Carol Couture is crying, please. I am calling her brother about her.
Who says I'm talking to? Good. I am calling about your sister, Carol Couture. She is blowing her car horn at the Red Crown Station. She is blowing and blowing her car horn at the Red Crown Station because my husband gave the station attendants instructions not to service her car. And she is blowing and blowing and blowing, drawing a big crowd there. And Mr. Couture, I thought you and your father agreed to keep that girl out of Two River Canyon for good. That's what we all understood around here. Well, I just want to let you know that she is back in town making another disturbance since my husband is on the phone right now at the Red Crown Station trying to get the sheriff's office. She gets picked up by the login, Mr. Couture. You can't say we didn't warn you.
Good. What good? What, where is she? Where's she going now?
Guess what you're doing, Couture. Yes, I sympathize with you and your father and with Mrs. Couture. But Carol cannot demand service at that station. They will refuse to wait on her. She's not. Hello? Hello?
What's he doing? Is he coming to get her? Why don't you just call the sheriff's office? You can't get in.
Look. Look, they're pushing her out of the station bathroom.
Where's Carol?
She's gone into the White Star Pharmacy. Lady, I want you to give me your word that if that Couture girl comes in here, you won't wait on her. You hear me?
Let's
no.
What? Well, you refuse to wait on her?
I cannot refuse to wait on anyone in my store.
Well, I'd like to know why. Because
I am on the phone.
Who are you phoning, darling?
The White Star Pharmacy. I want Mr. Kibinski to refuse to wait on that girl. I want the White Star Pharmacy.
No, she's still in the White Star.
Well, maybe they're not waiting on her.
Dubinsky? He'd wait on a purple-bottomed baboon if he put a dime on the counter and pointed at something.
Well, I happen to know that she sat at a table at the Bluebird Cafe more than half an hour last time she was here. The waitress has never come near her.
Well, that's different. They're not foreigners there. You can't ostracize a person out of this county unless everyone cooperates. Lady just told me she was going to wait on her if she comes in here.
Oh,
you.
Lady, wouldn't do that.
Well, ask her. She just told me she would.
I cannot refuse to wait on her just because they do if you don't like her. Besides, I'm thrilled that that wild girl is giving her brother so much trouble.
Mr. Kibinski, this is Dolly Hammer. Mr. Dole, here is mine. I'm going to ask you, is Carol Kibinski your brother's daughter?
No, she isn't.
What?
She's here. Hello, lady.
I thought for sure in New Orleans.
I was last night.
Well, you look back pretty fast.
And I drove all night.
And that's fun?
The wind took the top right off my car, but I didn't stop.
Is something wrong at home? Has someone see?
I wouldn't know. May I sit down?
Sure.
They pay me to stay away, so I wouldn't know. I feel like I have a fever. Like I'm catching pneumonia. Everything seems so far away.
Is there something that I can get for you, Carol?
Everything seems miles away.
I said, is there something that I can get for you?
Excuse me, yes.
Yes, what?
Don't bother now. Yeah. I'll wait.
Wait? Wait for what? Huh? What are you waiting for? Come out of my store and give it to you, huh? Now, get the phone.
Or I'm just going to wait here until she does what she knows.
She already said she would.
Well, just the same. I'm going to wait.
Yes, sir, she is. I'll tell her. Her brother's heard she's here. He's coming to pick her up.
David Couture is not coming into my store.
Uh-oh.
David Couture is with your wife.
I remember. You told me about it.
Eula, darling, what are you two doing back here dancing like this, huh? Why don't you go to the Bluebird and have some coffee and cocktail? Get up.
Well, looks like we're getting what's known as a bone stretch.
Well, I never stay where I'm not wanted. And when I'm not wanted somewhere, I'm never.
What do you want here?
To deliver a message.
A message? To me?
No.
Do you? Do you? Then you give him the message. Deliver the message to him, huh?
It's a private message. Can I speak to him alone, please?
brother's plantation is 10 minutes away from me in that Scotch Cadillac car it is.
I do not want him coming into the store. I don't even want his
hand to touch the door handle. Do you understand me? I know your message, and this boy knows your message. There's nothing private about it. That boy is not for sale in my store. Do you understand? Now, I'm going up in the highway to look for that car, and when I see it, I'm going to come, and I'm going to open the door, and I'm going to holler. And when I holler, I want you out of here as fast as they shot from a pistol. Do you understand me, Carol?
You told that lady I looked for, you got a message from her. Have you got a message for me?
He spilled some ashes on you when you blew the soup.
Without the message?
No. No. Who's this excuse to touch you? The message is...
What?
I'd love to hold on to something the way you hold on to that guitar. That I'd love to hold on to something. With that same tender protection. I'd love to hold on to you that same way. With that same tender protection. Because you hang the moon for me.
Well, you can't fool besides yourself. You couldn't stand the weight of a man's body on you. What's this? A human wrist for the ball? Looks like a tool got to snap with two fingers. Little girl. Little tramp. I can see the veins in you. Wait till a man on you will break you like a bundle of sticks.
Isn't it funny? But you hit on the truth about me. Find the act of love making almost unbearably painful. And yet, of course, I do bear it. Because to be not alone, even for a few moments, it's worth the pain.
Well, then, fly away, little girl. Fly away before you get broke.
Why do you dislike me?
I don't dislike no one. Till you interfere with me.
How have I interfered with you? Did I snitch when I saw my cousins watch on you?
You won't take my word for the truth that I told you. I'm done with the crowds you run with and the places you run to. The club rendezvous and the midnight bars and the music clubs and all the all-night places. Here, take this roll in this chronometer bag that tells the time of the day of the week and all the crazy moon faces. I never stole nothing before in my life. And when I stole this, I knew it was time to get off the party. So take it back. Take it back now.
No,
take it back
no,
and burn it!
No.
That's my message to you and the crowds you run with.
I can't leave her in the car.
I have something to tell you. I've never told you before.
I carried your child in my body this summer that you with me.
I didn't know.
No, you didn't know. I did not write you no letter about it. I was proud and I pride. But I carried your child in my body this summer that you with me. The summer that they burned my father's wine garden and you. You washed your hands clean of any connection with a what day of good lady's daughter. And took on that society girl who restored your home place and give you such well-born children, huh?
I didn't know.
No, well, now you do know. Now you know. I had your child in my body this summer that you quit me. And I had it cut out. And they cut out my heart with it. I wanted death then. But death don't come when you want it. It comes when you don't want it. I wanted death then. But I took the next best thing. You sold yourself. I sold myself. You was bought. I was bought. You made whores of us both.
I didn't want to hurt you.
But that was a long time ago. A few nights ago, I drove up there to the shore of the lake where my father had his wine garden. You remember the wine garden? No. You don't even remember it even, do you? And my father, all the songs that I sang with my father in the wine garden.
Yes. I don't remember.
Cara ingratia, come le rose. Oh, and we would disappear into the night, and my father would call out, lady, lady, how could I answer him and took down to my mouth, huh? I hold hard feelings! Don't you ever come here again! And don't you pity me neither. I haven't gone down so far in the world. I have a going concern in this confectionery back here. In the store. It's going to be like my father's wine garden. Those wine drinking nights when you had something better than you've ever had since!
Lady.
What? Go now. Just wanted to let you know that my life is over. Get out! Get out of here!
Have visions. And it did. I had them.
told me, be sure to empty this out on the ground. Well, I didn't. I was scared to go out at midnight with death in the house. So I sneaked in the kitchen, and I emptied the bowl of holy water down the kitchen sink. Thunder struck, and the kitchen sink turned black. Well, the kitchen sink turned absolutely black.
Mama?
Somehow or other, I just don't feel comfortable in this place. But I'm not scared.
Oh my God. The chain gang does.
Run more! Run fast, brother! If they catch you, you'll never run again! That's for sure!
wildwood cabins on the highway.
Do you like it there?
Uh-huh.
Why?
I have a two-burner stove, a comfortable bed, an ice box, and shower there.
Would you like to save some money?
There's a good amount of that.
Well, you could if you stayed on the place.
What place?
This place.
Whereabouts on this place?
Back of that curtain.
Where they try on clothes?
There's a cot there. The nurse slept there after Jake's first operation. There's a washroom down here, and I'll get the plumber to come in and put in a hot and cold shower for you. I'll fix it up real nice.
I'd like to be obligated.
There's no obligation. If you're doing me a favor, I'd feel safer in the place. I would. It would cost you nothing, huh? And the money that you save from staying at the cabin, what, 10 a week, in 2 or 3 months, you'd have enough to, why don't you go back there and see if it's all right? Where does he keep going in this building, huh?
Keep fast.
You? With your dog's temperature, you don't feel it, do you? I do. I turned blue with him. Well, why don't you go and take a look at it and see if it suits you?
I'll go look at it. So far, but I'd like to feel free to. That old life is what I'm used to. I used to work nights in the city. If you work nights in the city, you live in a different city than those old days. Those old days in the city, those that work nights in the city, they live in two different cities. Well, the city has the same name, but they are two different cities. Different night and day. Something wild.
Most people in this country, they think that ride on, with or without relations. As a little girl then, I remember, it took her such a long time to die. She sat there, alone in the corner, and I almost forgot about her. And I remember one day I asked her, Zia Teresa, how does it feel to die? Only a little girl would ask such a question. And I remember her answer, she said, it's a very lonely feeling. I think she wanted to stay in Italy, to be in a place that she knew. She wanted to die there.
I will get the plumber, to come in and put in there, and I'll shower for you. And I'll go upstairs and get the linen to make up your bed.
Me.
Oh my God, how you scared me.
You didn't expect me?
How did I know it was you that was coming down here?
I thought you'd give me a room here.
You left without telling me if you wanted it or not.
Can't you turn down something like that?
Yeah, well, you should have told me if you wanted it.
I thought you took it for granted.
Don't take nothing for granted, you wait.
You blinded me with that flashlight.
I did not make up your bed.
That's all right.
I brought the linen down, but you had cut out.
Give me back that name. I can make up my own rack. Tomorrow you're gonna have to find yourself a new clerk. Tell myself, a lucky night.
Did you just open up the cash box?
Why do you ask that?
That's why I come down here. I thought I heard it rain.
Can you pick the moment?
Did you just open up the cash box?
Who did it, Bobby?
Nobody did it. You didn't.
How come you didn't lock cash up in the safe this evening?
But sometimes I forget to.
That's curious.
Why did you open up the cash box, pal?
I opened it twice this evening. Once before I left and again when I come back. I borrowed some cash, I put it back in the box, like all this left over. I'd be a blackjack dealer 5 times straight. This kind of thing, I can retire for a season.
Chicken feet. I feel sorry for you.
Oh, you feel sorry for me?
Yes, I feel sorry for you because nobody can help you. I was touched by your strangeness. Your strange talk about the fur with no legs. I said to myself, this boy. He's like a bird with no legs, so he has to sleep on the wind. Just touched. You ruined my heart, my poor Dago heart. I was such a fool to even feel disappointed in you.
You disappointed me.
Yes, I was disappointed.
And I was disappointed in you.
Yeah, how did I disappoint you?
There wasn't no cop behind the mirror before. You put it
yes, there was. There was a photo behind the mirror.
What no
cop behind the mirror when you told me 3 times.
Yeah, and I put the money in here on purpose to see if I could thrash you, but I cannot thrash you.
You got back.
No, I know I cannot thrash you. If I cannot thrash you, I don't want you here. Do you understand me?
Okay, I respect no character.
Yeah, well, I'll give you a good character reference. I'll say that you're a peculiar slew for her, who is not a real hard worker, and who is not honest, but is a peculiar slew for her. Sweet doctor, while he's got his hand in the garage box.
You got back on my...
Oh, don't you mix up the issues, sir. I see through you.
You see through me?
Yes, I see through you.
I see through you.
Yeah, what do you see through me?
I see it. Not so happy. Cold one. Who hire a man off the street to pull double duty. But I'll pay overtime for it. I mean, a store clerk there, a stunt knife.
Willie Presper, you bastard!
Okay, you fell on me.
Why did you come back here?
To put back the money I owed you. So you wouldn't remember me, if not honest or grateful.
No. I need.